Do you remember the song Mercy being played at every party in 2008 and 2009? It's by the British singer Duffy, with blonde hair, dimples, and a very characteristic voice. Her talent was compared to Amy Winehouse and Adele, but she suddenly just disappeared. Recently, Duffy unexpectedly made headlines with a terrifying story that she went through in the past decade. Now she hopes that her confession will help her move forward. So keep watching to find out about the heartbreaking story that happened to Duffy. But first, don't forget to subscribe to Curiosips to stay up to date with our videos, and press the bell icon. Are you ready? Let's start. Let's be honest, Duffy is one of those stars who peaked very fast and then became the victim of the second album curse. I could also say a one-hit wonder, but that would be a bit harsh, so let's not. Anyway, let me explain and remind you about her success. Duffy, whose full name is Amy Ann Duffy, went to number one in 12 countries with her song Mercy. It was the third best-selling single in the UK in 2008, and her debut album Rockferry, which was released that same year, went 7 times platinum and it got her 3 Brit Awards, which are basically like the British Grammys. Duffy's debut album was also released in the United States. It got positive reviews, and in 2009, it even won the actual Grammy for Best Pop Vocal Album. It seemed like the singer's label was ready for her to take over the world, as Duffy performed at concerts and the biggest festivals around the world and promoted her music on popular talk shows. That sudden success clearly overwhelmed her, because she even considered quitting music and felt like she needed to take a break to write her second album. Unfortunately, her sophomore record Endlessly didn't do as well as the previous one. As a result, Duffy announced that she would be taking a break to focus on her third album, which never happened, and there are slim chances that it ever will. Then Duffy just disappeared, and it seemed that everyone forgot about her except the radio stations that still sometimes played Mercy. It had been like that until the end of February of this year. That's when Duffy took to her Instagram account, and in a now-deleted post, wrote that she had been sexually abused, drugged, and held hostage over some days. She had disappeared from the spotlight so she could recover, and it has taken her some time, but she's doing well now, and she's ready to tell her story. She promised to give an account of what happened to her, why and where she disappeared in a longer statement. Duffy decided to make her story public only because a journalist found a way to reach her last summer, and she told him about everything she went through. So it took her some time to write down her experience, but it's finally here. On the website duffywords.com, the singer wrote an essay titled Fifth Home. She wasn't sure if she should have released her statement now, in the time of a worldwide pandemic and national lockdowns, but she hoped that her words could be a short distraction, or they may even bring someone comfort and help them. So Duffy explained that she posted her first statement because she was tired of hiding, never feeling free, and carrying a burden. Because of what happened to her, she even thought of changing her name, moving to a foreign country, and starting a completely new life, just to leave her past behind and not trouble anyone with it. But she realized that she couldn't keep hiding. She dreamed of having a romantic partner and of starting a family, but was also scared that her confession would influence her future love life. Duffy also worried about coming back to music and having to face the questions, what happened? What have you been up to? And why did you disappear? She couldn't imagine having to make up some story about how she'd been traveling across the world. She'd even been warned not to open up because it could potentially finish her hopes for having a music career again. Because literally, no one except those close to her knew what happened, not even the industry people she used to work with. So here's what Duffy went through. Just a disclaimer, it's very upsetting. It all started on her birthday, no specific date. Duffy was drugged at a restaurant, then it continued for 4 weeks and she was taken to a foreign country. She couldn't remember getting on the plane. She only came round in the back of a traveling vehicle. Then she was put into a hotel room and that's where she was sexually abused. Duffy had to stay there with the person who hurt her for a few days. She thought of escaping, but was scared that he'd call the police and she would be tracked down as a missing person. She still doesn't know how she had the strength to live through those days, and neither do I. Then Duffy flew back with him. She stayed as calm and normal as a person in that situation could. After they returned, she was held captive and still drugged in her own home. She was like a zombie, but she knew that her life was in danger because the man threatened her. She wasn't aware of much of what happened in the house. She only remembered escaping in the following days. After that happened, the singer still lived like a zombie. She would stand on the balcony wrapped in a blanket and stare into space. She didn't feel safe going to the police. But during different threatening incidents, she told two female police officers about what went down. Once, someone threatened to out her story, so she had to tell the officer what that person knew about her. Then, three men tried to enter her house as intruders, so she told the second police officer about the abuse. And the first person Duffy really opened up to was, of course, a psychologist, and that's the person she credits for her recovery. In the following 3 years after the incident, Duffy moved 5 times because she never felt safe. She was scared that her abuser would somehow find her. The 5th house she moved into was where she finally felt safe, because it wasn't as confined as the previous ones, and that's the place where she slowly recovered. Duffy found it strange that she's sharing her experience of isolation at this point in time. She added that, from a psychological point of view, isolation is a form of torture, but in the current situation, it's what can save lives. At the end, Duffy said that she will now go back to quietness. But what about her music? She thinks she owes it to herself to release some kind of record, but she will never be the same person people once knew. The singer also sent an unreleased song titled Something Beautiful to a BBC Radio 2 DJ that was played on the show. I'm just amazed at how strong Duffy is. Can you imagine what it must have taken to make the decision to share her story? I hope that she will finally be able to live her life in peace and that she finds real love. Do you think that Duffy will ever release music again? Or will she live a private life? Let me know what you think in the comments, and remember to subscribe to our channel to stay up to date with our celeb videos. Also, share this one with your friends. See you soon.